Today we are going to discuss about profit and loss appropriation. Profit and loss appropriation. Profit and loss appropriation account is an extension to profit and loss account, which is prepared to appropriate the net profit. It is prepared to appropriate the net profit. What are these appropriations? Appropriations are appropriation of amount which are payable to the partners, or appropriation of amount which are to be transferred to general reserve or any other reserve, and adjustment of interest on drawings, all those things. So in order to make all these adjustments, we will prepare a separate account which is called as profit and loss appropriation. So profit and loss appropriation account is an extension to profit and loss account. Why it is an extension to profit and loss account? Because it is preparing after, or it is preparing just after the preparation of profit and loss account, and this account starts with the net profit or net loss derived during that period. Net loss or net profit will be derived by preparing the profit and loss account. So with that profit, we prepare the profit and loss appropriation account. So profit and loss appropriation account is an extension to profit and loss account, which is prepared to appropriate, which is prepared to make some appropriations. These appropriations are the amount payable to the partners, or amount which are to be received from the partners, or the amount which are to be transferred to capital or general reserves. So here, how to prepare the profit and loss appropriation account? That is what we are going to discuss. We are going to solve a problem. So while discussing a problem, we will tell that how to prepare profit and loss appropriation account. Here is an example. A, B and C are partners. A, B and C are partners. Their profit sharing ratio is 2:1:1. That is their profit sharing ratio. They share the profit in the ratio of 2:1:1. And their opening capital is 2 lakh, 1 lakh, and again 1 lakh. That is their opening capital. And they have to get interest on capital at the rate of 5%. That is common for all. Interest on capital, 5% they have to get. And they have to get salary as well as commission also. Salary, they have to get, for example, B has to get salary of 1,000 rupees per month. 1,000 rupees per month. Then there is a commission which is payable to C, that is 10,000. 10,000 commission is to be payable to C. So far. Profit sharing ratio is written, opening capital is written, interest on capital to be payable to all, it is payable to A, B and C, then salary is payable to only B, no need to pay for A and C as per the partnership agreement. Then commission is to be payable to C only. Then during the year, some drawings were there. Drawings, A will do rupees 30,000 and B will do rupees 10,000. C has no drawings. So for that, interest on drawings is there. Interest on drawings profit sharing ratio is given, opening capital is given, interest on capital is given, salary, commission, then drawings, interest on drawings, and how much profit is to be transferred into general reserve. That also a part of the profit is to be transferred into general reserve. So when taking this example, we are preparing profit and loss appropriation account. This rupees, how much can be given? Suppose 80,000. 80,000 is the profit before making all these adjustments. So that is the profit. With that profit only we can start the profit and loss appropriation. We know that net profit we will get as the balance of profit and loss. That balance we will get, if there is profit, we will get the balance on the debit side of the profit and loss. Where we used to write net profit transferred into capital account or net profit carried out. Suppose there we are writing net profit carried out. That net profit will be brought down here. So which side it has to write here? It's an income to this business. So this is a nominal account. So all the incomes are to be shown on the credit side. So by net profit brought down. If it is net loss, to be shown on the debit side. Yes. So net profit, how much is there? 80,000 is there. Then opening capital is there. Interest on capital we have to. Interest on capital is an expense. So to interest on capital, we can write separately for A, B and C. Yes, capital is 2 lakh. So it's 5%. How much? 10%. So for A, 10,000. B, 5,000. And C, again, 5,000. So total interest on capital is 20,000. Clear? Any doubts? Yes. Then next item. Salary. Whose salary? B's salary. B's salary. How much? 1000 rupees per month. So 1000 into 10,000. Okay. Then next, B's salary is given. After that, commission. Whose commission? C's commission. How much directly given? 10,000. So 10,000 for 1 year. So 10,000 is given. So we have taken interest on capital, salary, commission. This much is over. What is next? Drawings cannot be written here. This is a deduction from capital. We will take there only. No need to write here. Next here, this one interest on drawings. Interest on drawings 10%. 10% of 13,000 and 10,000. See, here we have, in the last class we have studied about calculation of drawings. So, in calculation of interest on drawings. There we have calculated interest on drawings on an average. So, various methods around 11 different situations for calculating interest on drawings we have studied. So, in those cases, their dates were given. Here there is no date. If date of drawings is not given, 1500. Like that for B. Base interest on funds. Is equal to 10,000 into 10% into 6/12 is equal to 1000. It's half. So these are the amounts of interest on funds. So that we can write here.
Half of the profit will be divided equally, means here 36,000.
16,000, that is the half of 36,000, they will share equally. So that we have to adjust, and remaining 18,000 will be sharing their profit sharing ratio. That's it. So that we have to discuss. So interest on drawings is clear. Thank you.